Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to your English class. Today, we will be having a recap on the story, The Magic Porridge Pot. I'm going to read it to you. Please listen and watch carefully. The Magic Porridge Pot. Imagine if you had a magic pot that could cook anything you wanted. Read the story to find out what may happen. Larissa lived with her mother in a small village in Meghalaya. Her mother earned money by selling palm tree brushes in the market. She did not earn much. One day, Larissa's mother fell very ill. She could not earn any money. There was nothing at home to eat. Larissa went out to gather jackfruit for them to eat. Jackfruit was plenty and people could gather it for free. Before we proceed, let's answer first that question on the right corner. What did Larissa go to collect from the forest? Is it the ripe bananas or ripe jackfruit? The answer is yes, it's ripe jackfruit. Okay, let's continue. As she bent down to pick a nice ripe jackfruit, someone said, "Why are you collecting jackfruit?" She looked up into the kind face of an old woman with a basket on her back. "We have nothing to eat at home, Grandma," Larissa replied. "Oh, poor you. Let me give you something." She pulled a small pot from her basket. "This is a magic pot. Just say, 'Cook good food, little pot,' and it will cook good food for you. To stop it from cooking, just say, 'Stop, little pot, stop.'" "Thank you." Larissa dropped the jackfruit and ran home with the magic pot. "Cook some nice porridge, little pot," she said, and the pot cooked delicious porridge. "Stop, little pot, stop," Larissa said, and it stopped cooking. Larissa and her mother ate the tasty porridge. After this, they had nice food every day, and her mother soon got well. One day, Larissa was out with her friends. Her mother wanted to eat some porridge. She said, "Cook nice porridge, little pot." Soon, the smell of porridge filled the room. Her mother ate the delicious porridge till she was full. She wanted the pot to stop, but she could not remember the exact words. The pot went on cooking. Porridge spilled over the floor and flowed into the street. Larissa saw the porridge in the street and understood. She ran home and said, "Stop, little pot, stop." The pot stopped cooking. Larissa taught her mother the magic words that made the pot stop cooking. They lived happily ever after. Now let's answer this reading exercises. Letter A, read and answer. Number one, say whether the statements below are true to the story or not, or false. Letter A, Larissa lived with her parents in a small village in Meghalaya. Is it true or false? Yes, true. Okay, next. One day, Larissa's mother fell ill and could not earn any money. True or false? True. Next, letter C. Larissa went to the market to ask someone for food. Did Larissa do that? No. So the answer is false. Then letter D. An old lady gave her a magic pot. Of course, this is obvious. Yes, true. Letter E. She taught her the magic words for it too. Is it true or false? Yes, it's true. What were the magic words actually? Cook good food, little pot, and once Larissa wants to stop the little pot in cooking, she has to say, "Stop, little pot, stop." Okay, now letter F. Larissa and her mother ate the food the magic pot cooked. Yes or no? Yes, it's true. One day, Larissa's mother asked the pot to cook some soup. Is it true or false? It's false because she asked the magic little pot to cook porridge. Okay, letter H, when she wanted to stop it, she could not. True or false? True, she could not. Letter I, so the porridge peeled on the floor and flowed into the street. Did it happen? Yes, it happened because she had forgotten the magic words for the magic pot to stop. Letter J. It stopped cooking when Larissa said the right magic words. True or false? True. What was the magic words for the cooking pot to stop? Stop, little pot, stop. Okay, number two question. Larissa dropped the jackfruit and ran home with the magic pot. Now, why did Larissa drop the jackfruit? What was the reason why she dropped the jackfruit? The options here are letter A, it was not ripe enough to eat. Letter B, it was too big for her to carry. Or letter C, she did not need it anymore. So the answer here is letter C. She did not need it anymore. Okay, next question number three. Larissa saw the porridge in the street and understood. What did Larissa understand? Letter A, that the porridge was nice and tasty. Letter B, that her mother did not remember the magic words. Letter C, that the pot was doing its work quite well. So the correct answer here is letter B, that her mother did not remember the magic words. Now let's try to answer letter B, okay? Try to think of your own answer here. Number four, do you think Larissa's mother was careless? Who says yes or no? Do you think she's careless? You can say she is because she had forgotten it, but you could also say not really careless because she just had forgotten the magic words. Okay, number five, if you had a magic cooking pot, what would you like it to cook? For me, if I have a magic cooking pot, I like it to cook porridge too. Okay, that is all for today. Thank you so. Now for your homework, I want you to read the whole story and record it. Send me your recording after you finish, okay? Letter B, answer reading exercises in your book only. Letter A and B.